Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pi My Life Up. In this video, we'll be showing you how to set up Audiobookshelf on your Raspberry Pi. This software is aimed at providing you a place to store your audiobooks and podcasts. You can think of this software as being a bit like Plex, but being aimed entirely at handling your podcasts and audiobooks. It has a ton of functionality built into it that allows it to automatically get metadata for your various audiobooks or podcasts. It even has functionality for it to automatically download podcasts as they're made available. To run Audiobookshelf on your Raspberry Pi, you will need to be running a 64-bit version of Raspberry Pi OS, or a similar 64-bit operating system that can run on your Raspberry Pi, such as Ubuntu. This requirement to use a 64-bit operating system means you must be using a Raspberry Pi 3 or newer. Additionally, you will need to install Docker to your Pi. If you've never installed Docker before, we will link to our guide on this below. Once you are ready to proceed, open up the terminal on your Raspberry Pi or connect to it using SSH. The first thing we'll want to do is ensure our Raspberry Pi's operating system is up to date. The first part of this process is to update the package list by typing in sudo apt update and pressing enter. Once the update completes, you will then want to upgrade any out-of-date packages by typing in sudo apt upgrade -y and pressing enter. Our next step is to create a directory where we will store the Docker Compose file for the Audiobookshelf software on our Raspberry Pi. To create this directory, type in sudo space mkdir space -p space slash opt slash stacks slash audiobookshelf. With the directory created, we want to change into it by typing in cd slash opt slash stacks slash audiobookshelf. We can now begin to write the compose file that will set up Audiobookshelf on our Raspberry Pi by typing in sudo space nano space compose.yaml. A compose file is basically a way for us to instruct Docker on how to set up a particular container or set of containers. Start off this file by declaring a list of Docker containers by typing in services followed by the colon symbol. Underneath this, define our first Docker container, which will be called Audiobookshelf, followed by the colon symbol. After this, we must tell Docker what image it should use to set up this container. Define this by typing in image colon symbol space ghcr.io slash advplyr slash audiobookshelf colon latest. With this line, we tell Docker to download the latest available version of the Audiobookshelf image from the GitHub container repository. Next, we need to set the ports that will be exposed from this Docker container so that we can access Audiobookshelf's web interface. Start by defining a list of ports by typing in ports followed by the colon symbol. Underneath this, type in hyphen space 13378 colon symbol 80. With this line, we expose port 80 from the Docker container using port 13378 on our host machine, which in our case is our Raspberry Pi. We now need to define some volumes. These volumes will give us access to the audiobooks or podcasts kept on your Raspberry Pi, and will also give a place for config data to be stored. Define a new list of volumes by typing in volumes followed by the colon symbol. Let us then start by defining a volume where our audiobooks will be mounted to. To do this, type in hyphen space followed by the path to where your audiobooks are stored on your Raspberry Pi, which in our case is slash home slash pi slash audiobooks. Follow this up with the colon symbol, then slash, then followed by a mount path on the Docker container itself. In our case, we're going to be using audiobooks. This can be whatever you want, as long as you remember it for later, as you will need to add this within the Audiobookshelf web interface. You can define as many volumes as you want, but for us we only have audiobooks, so that's all we're going to mount. Once you have all your volumes defined, we then need to set a volume for the config directory. To this, type in hyphen space dot slash config colon symbol slash config. We then need to define a mount path for the metadata. Do this by typing in hyphen space dot slash metadata colon symbol slash metadata. Both the config and metadata files will be stored within the slash opt slash stacks slash audiobookshelf directory that we created earlier. We will now want to define an environment variable so we can set the time zone that this software will be running under on our Raspberry Pi. Define a list of environment variables by typing environment followed by the colon symbol. Now underneath this, type in hyphen space TZ in capital letters equals followed by a valid TZ identifier. In our case, you'll be using Australia / Hobart. If you don't know your TZ identifier, we'll leave a link in the description below that will show you where you can find these. Finally, let's ensure that Docker will automatically restart Audiobookshelf on our Raspberry Pi by typing in restart colon symbols space unless hyphen stopped. With the file now written, we can save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X and then Y and then Enter. With the compose file now written, all you need to do to start up Audiobookshelf on your Raspberry Pi is to type in docker space compose space up space hyphen D. This will download and run the Audiobookshelf Docker container on your Raspberry Pi. As we are running it using the hyphen D option, Audiobookshelf will continue to run in the background even after your Raspberry Pi is restarted. With that done, we can now access the Audiobookshelf web interface. Open up your favorite web browser and go to http://, followed by the IP address of your Raspberry Pi, followed by a colon symbol, and then the port 13378. If you're using the web browser on the same machine you're hosting Audiobookshelf, you can just use localhost instead like we are. Alternatively, if you don't know the IP address of your Raspberry Pi, we'll link to a guide on how you can find this below. The first time that you open up Audiobookshelf, you'll be asked to create the admin user. Give this user a name and then type in a password that you'll use to log into your account. Everything else can be kept the same and then click the submit button. You can now log in using the details that you just set. For our example, this means we'll use the username PiMyLifeUp and the password that we typed in. You can then log in by either clicking the submit button or by pressing enter. The first thing you want to do when loading up Audiobookshelf is add a library containing either your podcasts or audiobooks. Begin this process by clicking the add your first library button. The first thing you'll want to do is select the media type. This will either be audiobooks or podcasts. Once set, you'll then want to give this library a name. In our example, we'll be calling ours audiobooks. With this set, we'll then want to select the folder where this data is stored. In our case, this is / audiobooks. It is possible to have multiple folders assigned to the one library. With everything set, click the create button. Audiobookshelf will now automatically scan this directory and add any of the audiobooks or podcasts it finds to your library. You can find these by returning to your dashboard by clicking the icon in the top left-hand corner. At this point, you have successfully set up Audiobookshelf on your Raspberry Pi. If you liked this guide, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.